up next is Candace Jedrowitz. Now, she is creating a personalized project for your pet. Hi, Candace. Say hi.
Hi.
Thanks, ladies. I see you're having too much fun as usual. This is my grand dog, Hershey. He and I are going to make a project today for our first dog, his Uncle Conan. It's going to be a plaque made from a peanut butter jar lid. I'm not going to tell you any more about it. I'm going to show you. You will want to start out with a fairly large jar lid for this project. And because we want to hang it and dangle something from it, we have two holes in the top. A wire will go through both and make a handle at the top to hang it, and three at the bottom for those dangly things. Now, in the center, you'll want to put something that represents your pet. Mine's going to be a dog paw. So I've got that little crab shell shape to start with, and then the little toes. And it could be anything at all, so let your mind work. And I used a little bit of the transparent to make a bone shape to go underneath that. And then I have some of the turquoise colors to make stones with. And what I used these for was to hold the letters. Here's one of the letters. And these were metal brad letters. I cut the brad part off of it and pushed them into the clay before I baked it. But you could stamp letters or glue on some other kind of letters once they're baked. And the sky is the limit. Now the other part was the little granite stones that just look amazing when they're cured in the oven. So glittery and very stone looking. Now, if you were making this for a cat, you might want to make a tiny little fish bone to put under the paw, or anything else that would go with your pet. Bake the pieces according to the directions on the package for the clay. I just happen to have a little bit of packing foam here, and I wanted to build up a couple layers of it so that I can bring all of my pieces up a little closer to the surface. Go ahead and glue your first layer of foam into place. Make sure that it's securely down inside of there. And then let's look at some wiring. This is about 7 or 8 inches, I guess, of 20 gauge wire. And I've already put some beads on because I'm ready to make it into a handle. To add that little extra bling with these tails, you will use a round nose plier and start to curl them. I'm just going to make a little spiral. Just a little bitty one on this side. There we go. And a slightly bigger one on this side. Let me do this so you can see it this way. And there is the handle. For the dangly parts, all we really need is an eye on one end and then crooked wire pieces, and that will help the glue hold the wire pieces in place so they don't come out. So just work them in one at a time. You do want them to be flattish. You don't want them to be a bump so that they would change the surface. because they were sticking up. So give them a little push down. To glue the second layer on, and because both layers are foam, so I'll be needing to stick them together very well, I'm going to use Aline's Foamtastic. And I'm going to be sure that I squirt it around all the way to the edge. Put a little extra on the wires. It doesn't matter what position they're in, as long as they're secured. It'll help if you leave a little bit of the foam glue right at the holes. That will help secure everything too. Get all of your pieces glued in place, and then when it's dry, before you grout, you'll want to attach your charms. I did three lengths of charms. Well, two. There's a long one in the middle and shorter ones on the sides. And when you put your wire in, you use just a plain old loop on the end, not one that's secured, because you want to be able to put your charms on. You want to be able to slide them on easily, and then you can close them up. And I have a little bit of sanded grout here in a pale color, like an almond, that I'm going to add a little water to. You'll want to mix your grout till it's about peanut butter consistency. And you can use any color grout. They come in all kinds of colors. And if you get it too thick, just add a little more water. I think this is going to be it. All right, I think that's it. I'm going to apply it with my hands. And I'm just squishing it in there. You'll want to get all around the edges. You want to work it down in to the cracks, because there's bound to be bubbles and pockets of air. And then just go back and take a little bit of it off. And when you see the air pockets, you want to get right on that. Force a little more down into there. Be careful that you're not taking away too much. Of course, you can always go back and put a little more in too. Let your grout get mostly dry, and then you can take a sponge back over it to clean a little more of the grout off of your pieces. I had drawn a design on my little bone, and a lot of it got sanded off, so I will probably go back over it with a felt tip pen again. There you go. And then you could add anything else that you want to it. You may want to go around the outside of it with a decorative fabric or ribbon or jewels, anything that you like. And I would love to see it if you try it. So I hope you will send me photos. Oh, also, while you have grout mixed up, it's a good idea to finish off older projects. Now I know you can't tell what this is, so let me tell you, it's a Cool Whip tub. That's right, it's a Cool Whip tub. I did some experimental things in here. I love watching Heidi do her mosaics. I glued some beads in between some of the stones. Looks pretty cool. There's some more. Awesome. Yeah, always keep projects going. When you're done with yours, you can certainly put a sealer on it, although it's going to hang on the wall so it won't make a big difference. You can certainly use a glossy sealer if you would like for it to look glossy.
What did you think about that, Hershey? Did you like doing that? Wasn't that fun? Your Uncle Conan is going to be so surprised. Pets are just a little bit of love in our lives. I hope that you get a chance to celebrate your pet. And I hope that if you do, you take pictures and email me so I can hear all about it. And then I can share it. Hershey wants to know, don't you, buddy?
Yes.
What a cutie pie. Bye, everyone. See you next time.